something else here. Let's talk about a movie. We got a couple of movies to talk about. So Will Smith and Antonio Fuqua, you know, the dude that did Training Day. They doing a slave film. It was bought by Apple.
Yeah, love a slave film. You guys, remember that time black people were collectively oppressed? That was a fun time, right? How about we put that in a movie?
Hey, man.
A movie. Yeah.
It's going to be good, man. Hopefully. Maybe.
I can't wait to read the news like articles about people saying, oh, man, it's a return to form for Will Smith. Such a socially conscious product. It's crazy.
Maybe our boy could finally win an Oscar with this shit, man. He doing a slave. He check all the right boxes, man.
Maybe nobody cared about the concussion movie.
I mean, but that's different. This is about slavery. You know what I'm saying? I mean.
Remember that movie with a terrible accent?
Don't even remind me of that shit, man. The trailer was probably the best part about the movie, man. Like, you didn't even have to watch the movie. Just watch the trailer. Because all the best shit is in the trailer. Tell the truth. Like, that scene is in the trailer, man. But, so the film will tell the true story of Peter, a runaway slave forced to outwit cold-blooded hunters and a punishing Louisiana swamp on a treacherous journey to the Union Army and his only chance at freedom. So, yeah.
Oh man, low-key the only slave thing I want to watch now is like an adaptation of Ta-Nehisi Coates' like lost book that he released, The Water Dancer. That's the only thing I really want to see as far as slave fiction goes.
Yeah, I heard of that. I didn't read it though.
That book is excellent. That's one of the best books I've ever read and the best book I've read this year. So.
Does it add new elements to the slave genre?
Oh, 100%, dude. And also, like, there's a specificity to it. Like, the basic idea is the main character is half white because he's the son of a slave master, right?
Okay.
And what's happening is that he's being raised to aid his incompetent, like, fully white half brother that is set to inherit the entire plantation. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's the idea that, like, you're literally raised next to your brother that is everything that you're not. And you're over here being raised to, like, do his job for him while he gets all of the benefit from that, while also basically selling yourself out for this entire system that you disagree with. It's crazy. It's so interesting, man.
Okay.
It's so cool.
Okay. That sounds interesting. Hopefully, but I don't think... I don't think they want to do slave movies like that, Mo. I think they are fine with the current
formula. They don't want to do something interesting?
They're fine with the current formula. And I don't think anybody wants to change it up because they want to win that gold naked man. So
I feel like true equality is when we start getting movies with black people in them that don't need to have black people in them just because it doesn't matter and we should hire black people because they're people too, you know?
Yeah, that's
like where's the movie about the dentist but they're just black and they never really be like, yo, this nigga black though, he black and a dentist.
Exactly.
You know, he's a dentist.
You're not gonna get that at all. Always typecast it, man.
But his blackness needs to serve a function. Why make him black if we're not using him being black? It's like, why make him white if that's never played a factor in any story ever?
Exactly. Exactly. You know what I mean? Yep.
Like, we never talk about that. Like, white people don't take on a racial context until we place them next to white people, like next to black people. You know what I mean?
That's exactly. It's like, yep.
That defaultness is what we want, man. I want black people to be default. Like, I want them to be normal. I want them to just be in movies and be like, oh, look, that's just another black man doing people shit.
I mean, it's just that so much that happens to us because of, white supremacy, systemic racism. So much of the stuff that happens to us is seen as just our issue and not the issue of the country itself or the country that we live in, so...
Oh, for sure, yeah.
And that's the issue. That's the problem right there. That's why they never ask a white person. Like, they never ask any of the white quarterbacks about the kneeling down or anything like that. They just ask the black people. Like, anything racial happens, they just ask the black people. They never ask white people. Unless it's, like, tied to white person.
Don't challenge these studios, dog. Like, you got, like, some guy said he didn't want Idris Elba to be James Bond. They gave you a black woman instead. They said, not only are they going to be black, they're going to be a woman, too. Like... You guys over here fighting this shit. They're gonna hit you with something even harder next time, man.
And let's not pretend like it's because they care. It's because it sells, man. Like, I know that the slogan was get woke, go broke, but that's not the case. You know, get woke, get tons of money, nigga. That's what's happening right now. So that shit don't work, man.